it's Julie. Welcome back to Roe & Co. Farms. This morning, we are going to be moving our meat chickens from the brooder into the chicken tractors that we've built. That's one of the chicken tractors over there. Chicks are about 3 weeks old now, and we're going to get those guys moved onto grass now for the first time today and start their process of being pastured chickens. So guys, here we are. You can see our two brooders that we had set up. If you followed back with our last video, I'll link it up above, but you can see where we first put our chicks in the brooder and this whole setup if you're interested in looking at that. But these guys have grown so much and they have feathers now, so they're ready to come out of here. Look at this guy. What are you doing in there? So they're ready. I'm going to take them out today. If you guys aren't familiar with the story of what we're doing here with our meat birds, our family, along with two other families, have gone in together and purchased 140 meat bird chicks, and we're going to be raising those all together on one of the family's properties for 12 weeks until they're fully grown, and then we will be harvesting all those animals together at the same time. So our friends who live close by have volunteered to be the ones to have animals on their property this time, which is great. We don't have to come out every day and tend to them, but we do come out and help with any of the bigger projects that need to be done. And this is one of those, like getting all the animals moved into the chicken tractors for the first time and things like that. We also came out and helped build all the chicken tractors. So if you guys are looking for a way to raise your own meat, but you don't have your own property to do it, this could be an option for you. Find some local friends, other farmers that are doing something like this, and you can do it also. Just team up together. If it means you go out and help and move chicken tractors or whatever, then you go out and help do that. If it means you get your own meat for the year. So basically, hopefully at the end, each of us will get around 40 something chickens, but we have lost a few. Some snakes got in and killed 5 or 6 last week. So we have been on the lookout for, you know, more predators, but there's always a few losses along the way. But we hope that we don't lose any more now that they're going to be in these permanent chicken tractors. They'll have less options for predators to get in. So that's the scoop about the meat birds and why we're doing what we're doing with the meat birds. So hopefully that is something that you guys could possibly do as well. So our chicken tractors are a real basic design. Cattle panels with a tarp over the top, some 2x4s and 2x6s as the framework, and zip ties hold most of the stuff together. We made a feeding trough out of a PVC pipe and just sawed off. Thank you.
ordered that like 2 weeks ago to cut the doors, and then by the time we cut the doors, put them together, I don't know if that frame had...
All right, guys, we have completed our chicken tractors. All of our chickens have been moved into the chicken tractors. Each family got 43 chickens. So hopefully they will all survive for the next 9 weeks until we process them. So really happy with the way these guys are looking and how these chicken tractors turned out. So once a day, actually twice a day, we're gonna be moving these chicken tractors. Because there's 43 chickens in there, they're gonna really mash down a lot of that grass and eat it and make a mess in there. And so we're gonna move them twice a day to make sure that they always have fresh grass. They also have a nice big feed trough in there that will keep full. They'll be allowed to free feed as much as they like. And then there's 2 5-gallon buckets in the back to provide them with fresh water. And we'll be checking those every day as well to make sure that they have what they need.